Hello students, welcome to my class. In today's class we are going to learn the chapter surface area and volume of class 10. In class 9 we have already studied surface area and volume of various solids. So before going into the introduction of this chapter, let us recall the formulas what we have studied in class 9. So first we will start with the solid cuboid. Suppose if L is the length of the cuboid and B is the breadth and H is the height, what will be the lateral surface area? The formula for lateral surface area is 2H into L plus B. And what is the formula for TSA? TSA is 2 into LB plus BH plus HL. And the volume formula, volume is equal to L into B into H. Okay, so now we will go to the next shape, cube. So how to find the lateral surface area, TSA and volume of a cube? So let us see that. Suppose if the length of the side of a cube is A units, then LSA, formula for LSA, what do you mean by lateral surface area? It is the sum of all the lateral faces, sum of the areas of the lateral faces, and you know that the face, each face of a cube is a square, so its area will be A square, so the lateral surface area will be 4A square. Now TSA is the sum of all the 6 faces of a cube, all these 6 faces are square, so TSA will be 6A square. Now volume formula is A cube. Now the third shape is cylinder. So if the radius of the cylinder is R and the height is H, we can call this cylinder as right circular cylinder. We can call it as right circular cylinder because here the radius is perpendicular to the height. So for such type of solid, we will have CSA, curved surface area, instead of lateral surface area, we will use curved surface area, and the formula for CSA is 2 pi RH, and the TSA formula is 2 pi R into H plus R, and the volume formula is pi R square H. Now we have cone. If the radius of the cone is R and height of the cone is H and L is the slant height, so what will be the CSA of a cone? So the formula is pi R L and the TSA formula is pi R into L plus R and volume formula is 1 by 3 pi R square H. So, since the height is perpendicular to the radius, we can call this cone as right circular cone. Now we will go to the next solid, sphere. So, if the radius of the sphere is R, so here CSA and TSA are same for a sphere and the formula is 4 pi r square and the volume of a sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. Then the last solid shape is hemisphere. So if the radius is R, then the CSA of a hemisphere is 2 pi R square and the TSA is 3 pi R square. So how you will get TSA? It is the sum of the curved surface area and the base of the hemisphere. So you know that base of a hemisphere is a circle. So 2 pi R square plus pi R square. So that will give you the formula for TSA, that is 3 pi R square. Now the volume is 2 by 3 pi r cube. So these are the 6 solid shapes studied in class 9. Now in this chapter we are going to learn surface area of a combination of solids. So in our day-to-day life we come across many solids which are made up of a combination of two or more solid shapes. So how to find the surface area and volume of such objects? We are going to see now. Suppose if we have a solid made up of a cone and a hemisphere, or a cylinder with a hemisphere surmounted on both the ends, or we have a cylinder with a cone. So if you have these type of solids, then how to find the surface area of such a solid shapes? So in these type of cases, for finding the total surface area of the new object, it will be the sum of the curved surface area of, we can say that this will be equal to the sum of the curved surface area of the solids involved. So for finding the total surface area of such type of solids, you have to add the CSA of the solids involved in the shape. For example, for this figure, in figure 1, we have a combination of cone and hemisphere. So for finding the total surface area of this solid, you have to add the CSA of cone plus CSA of hemisphere. So what will be, how will you find the CSA of the figure? Then here you have a combination of cylinder with the two hemisphere. So we can say that CSA of cylinder plus 2 times CSA of hemisphere. For the third figure, CSA of cylinder plus CSA of cone. In this way, we have to find the total surface area of combination of solids. Now we are going to see few example questions. Now let us see the first example given in the textbook. Rashid got a plain top as his birthday present, which surprisingly had no color on it. He wanted to color with his crayons. The top is shaped like a hemisphere, cone surmounted by a hemisphere. The entire top is 5 cm in height and the diameter of the top is 3.5 cm. Find the area he has to color. So here in this question, the value of pi is given as 22/7. So what we have to do here? We have to find the area to be colored. So area of the top to be colored will be equal to the TSA of this toy. So TSA of a toy, of the toy. So what do you mean by TSA? We have already discussed, we have already studied in class 9. TSA is the area of the surface that is exposed to the space, or we can say that TSA of a solid is the area of the surface which we can touch or which we can paint. So here TSA of the toy is the, here we have a combination of cone and hemisphere. So for finding TSA of the toy, we have to add the CSA of these two solid shapes. We can find the TSA of the toy by adding CSA of cone and CSA of hemisphere. Now, what is the formula for CSA of a cone? Pi R L. What is the CSA of a hemisphere? 2 pi R square. So these two terms, we can take pi R common. So you will get L plus 2R. But radius we need to find out first. Diameter of the hemisphere is given as 3.5. So the radius will be 3.5/2. That is 1.75 centimeter. So diameter is given here. So we can find the radius. Now what is the height of this cone? How will you find the height of the cone? The entire height of the top is given as 5 cm and this portion, actually the hemispheres, this portion is the radius. So from the total height, if you subtract this radius of the hemisphere, you will get height of the cone. So height of the cone will be 5 minus total height minus the radius of the hemisphere 1.75. So the answer is 3.25 cm. So now you need the slant height of the cone. So we are going to find the slant height. So what is the formula for slant height? L is equal to root of h square plus r square. So these formulas and all we have already studied in class 9. So here we are going to substitute the values of h and r. H is 3.25. So 3.25 the whole square plus r is 1.75 the whole square. When you simplify, you will get the answer as square root of 13.625. So when you take the square root, you will get 3.7 centimeter approximately. This is the approximate value. Slant height will be 3.7 centimeter. Now we are going to substitute these values here. So pi is 22/7. Radius is 3.5/2. So 3.5/2. Value of L we got as 3.7 plus 2 into radius. 2 into radius is 3.5/2. So when you simplify this 2 will get cancelled, and this 7 and 3.5 we can cancel. So 22, this 2 and 11 also we can cancel, 12, 22 also we can cancel. So 11 into 0.5 into 3.7 plus 3.5. So when you add these two, you will get 11 into 0.5 into 7.2. So final answer is 39.6 centimeter square. So this is how we have to find the total surface area of combination of solids. Now we will see the next example question. Now we will see the second example. The decorative block shown in the figure is made up of two solids, a cube and a hemisphere. The base of the block is a cube with the edge 5 cm and the hemisphere fixed on the top has a diameter of 4.2 cm. Find the total surface area of the block, and in this question also the value of pi is given as 22/7. So here what we have to find? We have to find the TSA of this block. So TSA of the block. So you know that it is a combination of two solids, a hemisphere and a cube. But in this question, just by adding the CSA of a cube and a hemisphere will not give you the answer, because the CSA of the cube covers only these four lateral faces, but we have to add the base of the cube as well as the area on the top which is not covered by the hemisphere. So how will you find the total surface area of such a type of solids? So TSA of the block will be TSA of the cube. Okay, so TSA means all the six faces area. From that we have to subtract the base of this hemisphere plus base area of the hemisphere plus CSA of hemisphere. So when you simplify these, we will get the result. So what is the formula for TSA of a cube? 6a square. What will be base area of a hemisphere? Pi r square. And the CSA of a hemisphere is 2 pi r square. Okay, so now we can simplify these two terms. So you will get 6a square plus pi r square. Now what is a? A is the edge of the cube, that is given in the question as 5 cm, and the diameter of the hemisphere is given as 4.2 cm. From that we can find the radius. So 4.2/2. That is 2.1 centimeter is the radius. So now we are going to substitute these values here. So 6 into a is 5. So 5 square plus 22 by 7 into 2.1 into 2.1. Now when you simplify here, 5 square is 25. 25 into 6 is 150. Plus here 7 and this one we can cancel, 0.3. When you multiply these numbers, we will get 13.86. So the final answer will be 163.86 centimeter square. So this type of question, it is very important. It is not like a normal question. Here we are not just adding the CSA. So this is how you have to do. Now today we have completed the introduction of the chapter surface area and volume, and a few examples also we have seen. If you like my channel, you can share and subscribe. Your subscription, my motivation. Thank you.